It's just as awkward through these windows as it was through the windows at my last place. I just want to give you a quick little view here now of the street here tonight. It's Friday night, March 3rd. See all my weather stripping is what I expected. Coming up on me here, guys. Stuff here. Put up there a few days ago. Figured the heat would make it sweat off. Mosing on through to now, guys. Entering from different angles here. Main part of the room, of course. Again, at night, I don't think I've made a good one at night yet, guys. And much prefer the look and the feeling and the ambience here at night. And what I've got done in here, my little nook area in here, dear guys. I'll be doing more in here yet, I dare say. But for space, that's just meant to be storage, I think, overall. I think I'm turning it into a cute little, I don't even know what to call it, guys. I mean, I call it an office, a little study room, a little lounge room or whatever. It's my chair there to sit on and laptop set up here and so on that. And eventually, if I ever get television and so on that again, you guys, I got that all set up in here. And I don't know how I'm going to get hooked up into this little room here or whatever, but this is where I'll be watching TV and so on that as well. And my cute little I'm hoping I'm going to be able to convert it into a kitchenette area, guys, but I don't know. I'm pretty packed up with stuff there now, it says. I don't know how if I'll have any other place to put like the jackets and all that sort of stuff to set it up as a kitchenette area, ideally in the way I was envisioning it. And here in the washroom, and my little baby. I think there's mice in the place, guys. I'm not sure. She's there all the time. Just listening. Excuse the stuff on the countertop there now, guys. It's just finished my supper there, late supper, and just got the bowls there to wash out now for later on. And this washroom is still kind of a work in progress, so I don't want to be showcasing it too much there. And I prefer to have it this way most of the time, lamplight. Yeah, my baby. And again, little boo-boo. Yes, guys, I don't know what she's really, really, really fascinated with that around the toilet area sort of thing. I don't know if she hears something in the walls or something, or the water in the piping, or... No, guys, why should I freaking sit so you can see my face sensibly? I won't know now until I look at the video afterwards if I've got good lighting here or not. Yeah. Well, I don't know why I could do it, I suppose, but I don't like the look of it afterwards. So anyway, so today is, tonight, now, is Friday, March the 3rd, at just a little after 11 o'clock tonight, guys. first time. Just can't get this way. You can see how it just changes the look of everything. Just takes the warmth off somewhat. Oh, I think it does anyway. These main lights up here. But anyway, so you can see my face a bit better. So yeah, it's March the 3rd now, guys. It's 11:07, almost 10 minutes after 11 o'clock. Friday night, 2023. So I was out there earlier today, took care of some business and so on that I've been putting off now. Well, for the past month since I've been here anyway, trying to get my phone and cable and everything straightened up. So I had to, I went over to the village mall there, guys, where there's, I knew there were pay phones to use, and kind of a space off to itself somewhat to make the calls and so on, and next to some washroom, so that's the only thing. So there's a bit of people using hand dryers and all the rest of the while it's on the phone, kind of phoning things up a little bit, being able to hear the person on the other end. But so we've got my phone and cable and internet and everything all, well, as far as I know, it is disconnected now, finally. But I think they may have done it actually a few weeks ago after all, but they never got back to me to let me know that it was done. But anyway, it was kind of confirmed there this afternoon that it had been disconnected for a little while now. So that was good. That was a worry off my mind that they were going to charge me for another month that I didn't have, you know, I couldn't really afford to pay and so on. So anyway, so basically, yes, I want to get up there to the village mall to make those calls, to get that straightened up once and for all, and to arrange for the payments and all the rest of it, and how I'm going to get the payments taken care of, because I have no idea. Still got to get their equipment and everything back to them. They were going to charge me another $800 for that as well, and late charges on every single freaking month that I wasn't getting it back to them sort of thing. So the way they have things set up, I mean, it would have been forever if we're trying to get the freaking stuff paid off and so on. So about another freaking $490, and that's late charges there, guys. 2 months of late charges there, cunts. On the bill itself. And it would have been another $800 for the equipment and so on that I need to get back to them that they're going to charge me for. So I mean, it's like I would have been like months and months and months trying to pay all this freaking shit off if I hadn't contacted them today and tried to get things arranged and so on. So the thing with the equipment, I'm still going to have to pay that if I don't get the equipment back to them soon. So that's on my mind now. I got to try to get that back to one of their sales outlets. And the modem is still left at the old address, guys. I don't know what I'm going to do about that. Go back to there and contact people that's living there now, I suppose, and ask them if they just give it to me or what sort of thing. But if they, if the service provider doesn't get that back, I think they're going to charge me for that. And so that's more money I don't have to pay out for something I'm not using anyway. So it's so anyway, I went out and kind of got it straightened up today, sort of straightened up or took care of, but I mean, I'm no further ahead, guys, and still got that worry on my mind now for the next little while to try to figure out how I'm going to get that taken care of. I mean, I'm still on government assistance, guys. I mean, I'm always on government assistance. I mean, it's a mixed blessing. It keeps me alive, but I mean, I also got a overpayment notice today as well, and excuse my language, social services is going to take $300 out of me for the damage deposit that they paid that was kind of already taken care of it to some extent, because my brother had given me money a couple months back there to pay toward this place. So I could get it when I checked it out. It would just be there kept for me sort of thing, and I had to have money up front for that sort of thing. And the government here in Newfoundland, the backward, the selfish, self-centered, heartless bastards, basically. I'm sorry, guys, for my language, but it's basically, I don't know what else to call them. They know the whole setup. They know how you have to go about getting a place and securing a place and all the rest of it. You have to have money up front. And so if you try to figure out some way to do that for yourself, to take care of that for yourself, these assholes, these fucking heartless pricks in the government here and so on, will make you pay one way or another regardless. I think they'd just sooner see you out on the street, guys, with nothing to your name, rather than to figure out a way yourself to secure something for yourself rather than rely on them to take care of it all for you, sort of thing. Because if you had to wait to get a deposit off them, they have their own good sweet cursed time to do things and so on and that, and it wouldn't have been the owner wouldn't have gotten her damage deposit at the time she needed to get it, sort of thing. And I would have lost this place, guys. I would have lost this place, and I don't know how things would have played out. So I got an overpayment notice today that the money that they gave to go toward the damage deposit, they want back now, and how they knew that there was money put toward it already, I don't know. And so that's got to come out of me. So my assistance is going to be reduced a little bit more than it already is. And then I got this big, hefty, huge fucking bill I got to try to pay Bella Light now over the next coming months and so on that. So anyway, what can I say, guys? What can I say? I don't know how it's going to play out. I mean, the money's not there. I don't know how I'm going to pay it in tiny little dribs and drabs and bits and pieces and so on that. And then these fucking bastards at Bella Light, they're going to charge me late charges for every month that I'm behind on things. You know, which again doesn't help me. So you got the government that are total freaking pricks, and you got these big corporations that are total inconsiderate, heartless pricks. Everybody there to screw the little guy, guys. You know, left, right, and center. So it means like it's so fucking hard to get ahead, guys. Excuse the language again, but that's my frustration coming out. It's so damn hard to get ahead when you're on a low fixed income. I could be working, it could be the same damn thing, guys, okay? Don't look at me in these videos and judge me for being on government assistance and so on. I could have a janitorial job or something, getting paid and still be on a low fixed income and be no better off, okay? I mean, there are thousands, hundreds of thousands, probably millions of people all throughout Canada, all throughout the States, throughout North America and so on, in that boat, you know, who are working but still no better off than somebody on government assistance, you know? So I mean, people like myself, I mean, it's damn near impossible to get ahead, you know. So I've been this past month now, so you can see what I got done here, guys. All of February, it took me to get this unit straightened up to the level that it is there now. Okay, so it's at this level here now, and you know, I'm pleased with it now. I can move around here and all the rest of it, you know. But that took up all my time. We had bad weather and all the rest of it, you know. And that sort of kept me back as well. So now I got to cut this up quickly here now, guys, because I can't go over my 15 minutes here. So I'll do another one here for another few minutes now, another little chit-chat, and just leave it at that. So take care, God bless, and out for now. Bye-bye.